In our previous video, we looked at what an IP address is. So if you missed that, you can go ahead and check that out in the playlist. But now what we want to do is we want to look at where an IP address lives on our Windows 10 computer. So we're going to go to our Start menu on our Windows 10, and we'll click on Settings. And once we get to Settings, we'll click on Network and Internet. And then we're going to go over here to the left where it says Ethernet. And we're connected wired, although you can also see a wireless connection here if you have wireless and you're working on, say, a laptop, for instance. Let's go ahead and click on the Ethernet connection. And we can see that we have our IP address. We see the IP address itself, the DNS servers. We see the manufacturer, various different information. If you wanted to copy that, say, to a text, notepad, on a text file, you can click on Copy. Let's go ahead and click back. So another thing we can do is we can click and look at the more traditional way of seeing the IP address information. Let's clicking on the Network and Sharing Center. Let's click on that. Now you can also get to that by going to the bottom right where you see here and clicking on Open and Network and Sharing Center in case you want to get to a shortcut. All right, so now that we're here, we'll click on Change Adapter Settings, and we'll go ahead and right-click and choose Properties. So when we go to Properties, we can see all the different parts that are installed. Now, all of this has to do with TCPIP. Some of it does, such as we see IP version 4. We see IP version 6, although it has been uninstalled for this particular demo. And we see some other things like the link layer discovery mapper. We see a network adapter from Microsoft for multiplexer. You don't need to know about all those things at this point. The only thing we're really concerned about now is Internet Protocol version 4. So let's go ahead and click on Properties. And we can see that this is what's called a static IP address. And that's because the IP address itself has been manually entered. It doesn't say automatic. Such as we clicked here and we clicked here, then it would be automatically assigned to us by what's called a DHCP server, or a Dynamic Host Control Protocol server. And those servers basically just hand out IP addresses based on the scope that you create. But we're not going to worry about that now. We're just going to stick with the use the following address. I'll cancel that and go back into it again. And we can see our IP address, 192.168.15.20. And we can see our subnet mask. And you can see the way that the subnet mask lines up. It tells us which is our network and which is our host. So we can see the mask is masking off the network to the left. And we can see to the right where the zero is, that means that's where our hosts begin. If we look at the default gateway, this tells us where our doorway is out to the internet, like we talked about in the previous video. So in order to get out to the internet, we need to have that doorway. If we take this doorway out, then we can no longer get out. Then we have the DNS server. The DNS server gives us names to IP addresses. So if you wanted to go to google.com, you would have to have a DNS server. Now, in this case, our gateway is also the DNS server. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. Just depends on if you're working in an enterprise environment or just working from your home. So we see the DNS server. So if we took this server out, we took the DNS server out, then we would no longer be able to get to web addresses using a name. We'd only be able to use an IP address itself, which of course no one can easily remember. So we want to make sure we have a domain name service server IP in this list, or DNS is what we refer to it as. And that way we can get out to the internet. So let's take a look at this from a command prompt perspective. Let's cancel this, and we'll cancel it. And now we'll open up a command prompt. So we're going to right click on our start menu and click on command prompt. You can choose either admin or non-admin. It doesn't really matter. And so here is our command prompt. Now let's type a simple command, ipconfig. Hit enter, and look at that. We see the same information we just saw when we went into our network and sharing center and the IPv4 address. So we can see our IP address is 15.20. There's the same subnet mask, and there's the default gateway. Now, the ipconfig without any switches on it is a fairly simple command with simple results. What we want to do is we want to see all the results of our IP information. So we'll hit the space bar, /all, and hit enter. And now we see information about all of our network cards. So in this case, we can see that our IP address, we're a member of a domain called widgetllc.internal. There's the name of our computer. And if we go down a little bit, we can see the DNS information, such as the DNS servers. We can see the default gateway and the IP config information that we just saw earlier. We also see a Teredo tunneling information as well as ISOTAP. Now, what that is it's an IP version 6 converter for version 4. So that way, if you are communicating with any IP version 6 devices, whether internally or externally, then these two are going to go ahead and convert 4 to 6 and 6 to 4, so you can communicate back and forth between the two different types of TCPIP. So that's what that information is all about. Now, I've set up another computer on dot 21. So you can see here 15.20 is our IP address. I've gone ahead and set up another computer on 192.168.15.21. Let's see if we can communicate with it. And there it is. We type the word ping, and that's very similar to the way a sonar is, or maybe the way a bat sonar works as well. Send out a ping, see if you get a response. And that's exactly what happened here. We got a response. So that means that we are able to communicate with 15.21. Let's go ahead and switch over to 15.21 and see if we can communicate backwards as well. As you can see, 15.21 is a Windows 7 device, and we get to our IP information a little differently for Windows 7. So we go into our control panel, and from here we can click on all control panel items, and then we can go to, once again, Network and Sharing Center, and now this looks exactly like it did on the Windows 10 computer. So we can right click, we can go to properties, and we can see our IP information. And you can see it's 15.21. So let's go to a command prompt. We can't right click and get to it. We can do a left click and just type CMD, short for command. And we can type in the same ping command, ping 192.168.15.20, which is our Windows 10 computer. And we can see we can communicate with the Windows 10 computer. Very good. Let's go ahead and switch back to our Windows 10. We're back in Windows 10, and we know we can get out to the other computer in our network. Let's see if we can get outside even further, out to, say, a Google DNS server address. So we'll put in a public address. So you see 8888, and we see we can. But how did we get there? Well, we can use a tool called Traceroute, which we're going to go into further in a later video. But just to give you an idea of what it looks like, and we'll just choose minus D so it doesn't resolve all the IP addresses along the way. It goes a little faster that way. And we can see, look at that, we're hopping along. We see that we're going from one router to the next. We started at 192.168.15.1, and we're going from one router to the next router to the next router to the next router. And eventually, when we get to the end, then we have gotten all the way to our destination. So that's how we sort of trace the path that we get from our local computer to our destination computer. You can see all the way from here to there how we got there. Now, there's no more than 30 hops between us and the rest of the world. You saw that trace route saying, hey, I'm not going to do any more than 30 hops. That is the maximum. And that's an interesting story, because between your computer and the rest of the world, there's no more than 30 routers. So pretty amazing. You can get all the way around the world in less than 30 routers. So let's take a look at some other interesting information. Let's say for a second that we switch from our static IP address to a dynamic IP address. Let's see what happens. Let's see what IP address we get from our DHCP server. We'll go to properties, and we'll go to IP version 4, and we'll change from static to dynamic. There we go. And let's do an IP config. And look at that. We're at 192.168.15.139. So we're still on the same subnet. Remember before we started with the 192.168.15, and with the 255.255.255.0 subnet mask. So we're on the same thing. We're using the same gateway as well, but we received an IP address from a different, source from the DHCP server. Let's do the slash all one more time. And we'll see the name of, or the IP address of the DHCP server itself. Well, there it is. There's our DHCP server. This is the device that handed us our IP address, which is, once again, our router. So our router slash gateway is not just a router. It's also a DHCP server. It's also a DNS server as well. You have just witnessed TCPIP communication in action. Coming up, we'll discuss IP address structure to give you a better idea of how TCPIP version 4 works.